rise and shine.
Good morning. The current temperature is 8.8 degrees Celsius, and the relative humidity is 78% in your backyard, according to your Eve weather. The high for today is 8 degrees Celsius, and the low is 4 degrees Celsius. The chance of precipitation is 30%. You have three reminders today. Place grocery order, order a HomePod mini for the front entrance, and take out the garbage. Let's start the day with a recent podcast from HomeKit 5. Have a good day, Brad.
Welcome to HomeKit 5. I'm Josh.
I'm Braden.
This week we're going to talk about LG.
Hello, the Brad Lloyd, and welcome to my channel all about building a smart home with Apple HomeKit. If this is something that you're into, then please consider subscribing to my channel so you can find more of my videos just like this one. Today I'm going to be talking about the Eve Weather. This is Eve's newest weather station, and it comes with Thread. I've had a couple of weeks to test this out, and today I want to share my thoughts with you and help you decide if this is something worth adding to your HomeKit smart home. First of all, I want to say thank you to Eve for sending me the Eve Weather for my honest opinion and review, which I will always give you guys. I love that Eve focuses solely on Apple HomeKit products. I also appreciate that Eve has jumped on the Thread bandwagon and now has several products that support Thread. This includes the Eve Energy, Eve Thermo, Eve Aqua, Eve Window and Door, and yes, now the Eve Weather. As you guys know from my previous videos, I'm building up the strength of my Thread network and adding products as they're released. If you missed my review on the Thread-enabled Eve Window and Door sensor, then I'll link that up here as well as in the description. So what is the Eve Weather? This is an outdoor weather station that's IPX3 rated, and it works with Apple HomeKit. An IPX3 rating means it can resist water spraying at an angle of about 60 degrees, and it's suitable for most outdoor settings that won't encounter extreme weather, such as flooding. We'll see next winter just how this holds up in extreme cold. You can measure the temperature, relative humidity, and barometric pressure and get a 12-hour prediction forecast based on the data that it collects. Now, the data is stored locally, not on the cloud, and it can be accessed directly from the screen or the app. The device runs off of a CR2450 battery, which Eve says will last about a year. Replacement batteries sell on Amazon for only a few dollars a piece. Now, this replaces the previous Eve Degree. The Eve Weather comes with a larger screen that will show the temperature, humidity, and 12-hour trend compared to the Degree, which only showed the temperature on the main screen. But the biggest difference here is that while the Degree connected via Bluetooth, the new Eve Weather can now connect using Thread in addition to Bluetooth. I'll show you more about that later. So why use a weather station? Well, the Eve Weather isn't going to replace your local forecast, not at all, but it is a helpful tool. I don't know about you, but I often find my local forecast isn't always accurate. It'll give me a general idea, but I want something that'll show me weather data specific to where I live. I've taken some comparisons over the last week or so. While pretty close, there typically seems to be a difference of about a degree or so. There are a few ways that you can see this data. Now, first of all, right from the screen itself, you can see the current weather, the humidity, and the weather trend. From the home app, the Eve Weather shows up as both a temperature and humidity sensor, and you can also use Siri to get this information. Siri, what's the temperature in the deck?
It's 9 degrees Celsius in the deck.
But the best place to see your weather information is going to be from the Eve app. Now, generally speaking, I'm not a huge fan of using manufacturer apps, and it's not because they're bad, it's just because, for simplicity, I prefer using the home app. However, this is an exception with Eve. The Eve app is an excellent HomeKit app that allows for more complex conditional automations, and it's free to use even if you don't own any Eve products. Now, let's take a closer look at our weather data on the Eve app. The At a Glance page is basically a favorites page that you can customize as you wish. Now, I have mine set up to show just my Eve products, however, you can add any of your HomeKit products to the screen. Now, from here, I can see my Eve weather, I can see the temperature, humidity, and pressure. To view even more information, hit the I to view by the hour, day, week, or month, or hit the compare button to compare the previous time period. You can also export the data into a CSV file, which I don't think many people will do, but I think it's pretty cool, especially once you've had a couple years worth of data. I do wish there was a way to export all of the data together instead of having to download the temperature, humidity, and trend data separately. And I found it takes some finessing to break down the data into a useful pivot table. Okay, so let's talk automations. Now, you can use the Eve app to create automations, or rules as Eve calls them. Eve shows an example on their website of having a light turn on when it looks like there may be frost to let you know that you may need to leave early for work in order to scrape the frost off your car. Now, this is cool, but I'm probably gonna notice frost out my front window when I wake up. Basically, you can set up any temperature or humidity-based triggers that you can use to set scenes or control other HomeKit accessories. I'm definitely interested to know what kind of Eve weather automations you can think of. What do you think would be helpful? Let me know in the comments below. Installation is really easy. This can be mounted and hung with a screw, which isn't included, by the way. Eve recommends that it isn't placed in direct sun in order to provide an accurate temperature. Now, ideally, this would be placed outside a window where you could see the screen from inside, but I couldn't really find that place for me that was out of the sun. So I have mine installed on my deck, and it's off to the side where it's mostly shade. As for setting it up, it's really easy, as with any Eve product. Okay, let's get this out of the box. So what's in this box? This. It's basically it. You get your a little, comment instruction card. And that's it. So let's get this set up. As mentioned earlier, one of the major upgrades with the Eve Weather, as compared to the Eve Degree, is the ability to connect via Thread. Finding a reliable Bluetooth connection outdoors can be challenging. However, with Thread, you're more likely to find a solid connection, depending, of course, on your Thread network. To utilize Thread, you'll need a border router, which would be a HomePod Mini. Adding additional minis, like one in every room, or full Thread devices like the Eve Energy and the Nanoleaf Essentials lights will strengthen your network by providing more possible paths to reach your accessory. Let me demonstrate the difference. I have 4 HomePod Minis and several Nanoleaf Essentials lights that are all contributing to my Thread mesh network. I tested my Eve Weather at the edge of my backyard, on my front porch, and at the edge of my driveway, and I still maintained a connection in each of those locations. I could even go as far as the front of my neighbor's house and I was still fine. However, any further and my Eve Weather was non-responsive. To test the Bluetooth, I just disconnected my HomePod Minis. The Eve Weather will continue to work seamlessly by switching from Thread to Bluetooth. So when using just Bluetooth, I was still able to maintain a connection on the deck where I have installed. However, all of the other locations that I tested failed, including my front porch, which really surprised me. A couple of things that I would like to see. The screen is great, but personally, I'd love to be able to have a sensor outside that communicated with the screen that's placed indoors in a more convenient location. Another option would be if Eve had an optional screen that you could add. Maybe even their Eve Room that could show both indoor and outdoor data. More of an all-in-one package. The Eve Weather sells for $69.95 Canadian, and overall, I think it's a great product, and I'm looking forward to collecting more data over the months and even years. So does it make sense to upgrade if you already own an Eve Degree? I'm the guy that's probably always gonna upgrade to the newest version regardless. Though impartially speaking, there are definitely benefits if you like the larger screen and you wanna be able to see more information right from the screen. However, I think for most people, it's gonna come down to connection. If you have an Eve degree and you don't have any issues with it connecting to Bluetooth, then you're probably okay a little bit longer. However, if your device is constantly unresponsive or it's not placed in an ideal location because Bluetooth wouldn't reach where you wanted to put it, then upgrading to the Eve Weather is something that you should consider. I hope you enjoyed this review and you found it helpful. It would really help me out if you give this video a like and subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to hit the bell icon so you can be notified when I release new videos every weekend. Thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you soon.